Hi guys, how's it? I'm Panda T, and for those of you who don't know me, I'm a VTuber character who plays a variety of games, but I mostly grew my channel on a game called Roblox. Over time, I started a little gacha series over a year ago called The Revenge of the Dark King, but at what cost did that continue, and why did I decide to discontinue it and get it canceled and over? Well, trigger warning, as the next following parts contain mentions of self-harm, so please click away if you're sensitive, or if you wish to not watch, feel free to pause the video and expand the video description to find resources on help with self-harm. Harm crisis, as well as 24/7 hotlines. So, in today's video, we're gonna talk about Matt Coleman's downfall and why is he getting canceled, and how did it lead to this downfall. So, before we continue, please hit the like button, subscribe, and press the notification bell for the algorithm, because I know YouTube sometimes likes to censor topics like these, which are supposed to be morally discussed. So yeah. Anyways, let's get into the topics of that. So, I met Matt back in February of 2023 on Discord, on Gaming Mermaid's Discord server, when he was doing his Royal High Gacha movie project before completely giving up on it due to motivation and burnout, as it was too much on him. Afterwards, he moved on to True Monster Heart, which was his official voice acted series, and I was still in the process of working on The Revenge of the Dark King, which I had created a community for on Discord back in December of 2022, which I'm pretty sure everyone who was excited for the series was able to join the Discord and stay posted about what's going on. But around the summer of 2023, things unfortunately started to go south and took a turn for the worst. And in fact, the worst had yet to come my way. So what happened was one of Matt's former voice actors reached out to me and spoke up and revealed a dark side to Matt's behavior, and upon seeing evidence against him about guilt-tripping people and talking about how he would take his life because of his family drama and issues. Now, before you call me heartless, I want y'all to understand me that I also have had my set of family issues, but unfortunately, this does not justify this kind of behavior, and I will not stand for it. I also didn't like the pressure I got put through, because Matt gave suggestions literally 99% of the time, and I was starting to lose interest, and he started to take over the story, which supposedly was supposed to correspond with Gaming Mermaid, this series, the multi-series. So to say the least, the Dark King series ended up being really successful on my channel, because it had a good run on YouTube, with the series catching Gaming Mermaid's attention, for which I will remain grateful forever, and I'm very thankful for. And unfortunately, the series started not only bother me with so much pressure, but the Gaming Mermaid too. So, for the good of my well-being, I decided to discontinue the series. For good. But of course, before I shut down the entire series for good, Gaming Mermaid requested her OCs to not be used anymore for original mini movies or any type of series. So I decided to respect that request, and usually I would keep to myself, but the request stated the following: "To be honest, I feel like my own Roblox roleplay series has been taken over, and it's not even my own story anymore. The Revenge of the Dark King isn't something I created, and it's been bothering me for a long time. But I do not want to squash anyone's creativity. However, I need to ask to please not use my characters anymore for your own original stories. I know you, me, and other creators, and everyone else can make wonderful roleplay stories. I appreciate your support, but I don't want to have my own story derived into someone else's story. Thank you so much." But yes, after the series was shut down, I have decided to respect that because I don't know if I would have gotten myself in trouble if I didn't comply with that. So yeah. But back on topic for Matt, I remember how much he pinged every single time he greeted someone, and every time he had to suggest something, he was always a ping, a ping, ping, ping. And that was starting to get really frustrating for me. Unfortunately, I hit him with good amount of infractions, and well, I didn't hit him with infractions right away, but I hit him with verbal warnings that if he does it again, I'll give him an infraction. To which I did comply with that request, but I'm pretty sure I doubt he'd stop that. But unfortunately, turns out I'm with that series, I was not respected. I was not feeling respected, and I felt like my loss with that series was the respect and the privacy of my personal life, because Matt kept pouring in suggestions on which characters should be added into the series, as well as writing stories about them, which I found really sweet and nice that he was trying to help me out to recover from the burnout, but unfortunately that wasn't working in his favor because that just added more to my burnout. I'm super thankful to everyone who supported the Revenge of the Dark King, but unfortunately it has came to such closure. I thank you guys for the support on this series, and all I gotta say right now is please respect the people you work with on your projects and don't treat them like machines and treat them as humans. Because you never know what someone could be going through, because they could be going through even the worst time of their life. Basically, just have patience with them. Even if you have low patience, just have patience. Like, just have patience. Don't spam them, don't rush them. Like, just have patience and be patient with them. You can never go wrong with patience. So after lots of consideration, I decided it would be best, of course, to drop Matt from my team of people that I work with, because I can't work with someone who is overly pressuring you into doing stuff when you feel demotivated or can't respect the fact that you have a personal life outside of social media and you're busy. Of course, I will not stand with the behavior of guilt tripping people into stuff. Into stuff. You know. Yeah. But yeah, I cannot struggle enough but say that this is just not it. But this is just not the right way to go about guilt tripping people and using your family drama for clout. That this is just over top. This is just over top. I can't find the words to describe it, but yeah, it's just way over the top. But now from here, I'll let my good friend Eraser take over the video. Thank you guys for understanding if you stuck with this long with the video, and I appreciate all the support that you guys gave me throughout this series' run. Of course, please don't go out of your way to attack anyone mentioned in this video. This video is simply meant to speak up and spread awareness on the situation. Do not go out of your way to attack anyone. Thank you in advance. Now, Razor, take it over.
Hello, it's me, Razor47 here. I am here to talk about my experience with Matt as well as a shocking fact about him which really disgusts me. So, to start this off, I will be talking about how I met him and joined his series. I first met Matt Coleman a few months ago and we used to be really great friends. I once offered him to become his video editor for his series called True Monster Heart and he was really happy. Things were going well at first. I edited the famous Pizza Tower screaming meme for him and I was voicing his characters. If I remember correctly, they were Mayor Hirigdon and Vinny. However, one day, I retired from being Mayor Hirigdon due to my stiff-sounding voice and decided to stay as Vinny's voice, which he liked my auditions I did for him. This is where things later went off. One day, I was just talking around on Discord until Matt Coleman messaged me. To my shock, he told me that I didn't fit Vinny's voice at all for being too manly. This really offended me, as the deep voice I had was the same I had as a teenager myself, which was really harsh and stupid. But that's not the worst part. Matt would eventually exploit me by suggesting me and pressuring me to make more videos for him despite the recent meme videos being done by himself. What a jerk he is for wasting my time and giving me so much pressure that he made me suffer. The worst part came when I saw how Matt was wanting to buy rope to commit suicide just because his parents wanted him to be a real man and face the real world, which, in result, is done only for attention and manipulation. Seriously, Matt, doing self-harm to yourself will only cause more damage to your family and you shouldn't be really doing that, as this is guilt-tripping and it's a huge red flag that really crosses the line. My friend Chloe underscore Gadgetudes has also revealed that she felt uncomfortable with Matt talking to her. At the time this happened, Chloe was only a minor and Matt was literally an 18-year-old adult, which proves he also pressures minors to work on his series. What a creep he is. Anyways, Matt Coleman, if you are watching this, do us a favor and leave the internet for good, be a real man and get a job and listen to your parents instead of being a man-child. They were right about what they said to you and you just brought up the same topic way too many times to the point of guilt tripping by using a self-harm announcement all to seek attention. So yeah, Matt, me and my friends don't want to see your face anywhere again for what you have done. Alright, now with that out of the way. Thank you for watching this video and please, if you don't want Matt to pressure you, share this video as much as you can, so people would realize the disturbing dark truth about Matt Coleman. So yeah, this is Razor47, signing off. Bye, guys.